Have you tried using a microscope to read a chip's markings, only to find it completely unreadable, even if you zoomed right in? Sure, you could tilt the board and refocus the microscope to read it. But what if I told you that you could make your microscope do this? Let's do it. You'll need a microscope with an LED ring lamp, a sheet of adhesive polarizer film, a circular polarizer, and a way to mount the circular polarizer onto the objective lens. You'll also need a few simple hand tools. Stacking the polarizer film with the circular polarizer, this is the effect we'll see. We use this to attenuate the glare while letting the diffuse reflections through. Okay, let's do this. First, take the screws out of the lamp, then pop the cover out. Using the cover as a template, mark and cut a circle out of the polarizer film. Using the circular polarizer as a template, cut a hole in the circle, leaving us with a donut. Remove the backing film, exposing the adhesive side, and stick it onto the outside of the cover. Let's reassemble the lamp. We'll need to poke through the polarizer film to put the screws back in. The 3D printed mount can be printed as two separate pieces without supports. These two pieces need to be glued together. Screw the circular polarizer onto the mount, then screw the subassembly onto the objective lens, or Barlow lens in my case. The circular polarizer should be able to rotate smoothly. Let's have a look at what this thing can do. By rotating the circular polarizer, we're now able to reject some or all of the glare. We should now be able to see the chip markings extremely clearly. So, how does this work? Let's first try to understand the problem. Light from our lamp is reflected off our subject. The shiny parts reflect more light, and these specular reflections end up dominating the entire image. That is glare. The glare hides the dimmer, diffuse reflections which we might want to see.
And they need to be destroyed.
Enter polarization. Using polarizers to reduce glare isn't a new idea. It's commonly used in photography and sunglasses to filter naturally polarized light. We now know polarizers can block polarized light and let in unpolarized light, so we want our glare, and only the glare, to be polarized. The way to achieve this pretty much boils down to this. The first thing to note is that diffuse reflections are always unpolarized. Specular reflections are a bit more complicated. Specular reflections of dielectric materials can be polarized. Even if the incident light isn't polarized, light can be polarized by reflection. An example is water reflecting sunlight. The reflection is polarized, which can then be blocked by polarized sunglasses. In practice, we're not going to see this effect using the LED ring lamp with our microscope. The situation is different when light is reflected off non-dielectric materials. The polarization of the incident light is, for the most part, preserved during reflection. Since we want our specular reflections to be polarized, our incident light needs to be polarized. That's what the polarizer film on our lamp does. If we left it out, the polarizer on our objective lens wouldn't really do much at all. With everything in place, the polarized specular reflections can be blocked by the polarizer on the objective lens, leaving us with the glare-free, diffuse reflections. Mission accomplished. That's all for this video. If you've enjoyed it, please consider subscribing.